Add 35 plus 62.
Welcome to level 2. In this level, we will practice adding and subtracting numbers while learning some new strategies. Our quest today is to add 35 plus 62. We've added and subtracted two-digit numbers like this before. Could we use our place value skills from level 1 to help us solve this? Let's give it a try. There are so many different ways that we can add and subtract numbers. What is your favorite strategy to use? Number lines, drawings, and counting on are all amazing tools we've used before. Let's put one of these strategies to the test with this problem. 42 plus 23. We learned that when we count on, we start with the bigger number and count up the amount of the smaller one. So which number should I start with? That's right, 42 is greater. So I'll keep 42 in my head and count up 23 times from there. Let's try it together. 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52. Wait a second. This is taking a long time. I'll run out of fingers before I finish. Maybe I should draw a picture instead. What do you think? You're right. Drawing 42 objects and then 23 more, that's gonna take forever. And a number line would take up a lot of space too. It looks like as our numbers get bigger, some strategies will be quicker and more efficient than others. Can you think of any ways to add 42 plus 23 that won't take us so long? I have an idea. Do you see this pencil that just appeared in the corner of our screen? Whenever you see this, it's your signal to grab your pencil and follow along in your guided notes. This means we'll be writing, solving, and thinking together. Let's give it a try. Find your guided notes and get your pencil ready. Great, you have your pencil too. We've learned how to stack numbers using place value to help us add. When we do this with two-digit numbers, we need to make sure to line up the tens and ones carefully, like this. But which one do we add first? Yes, when we add vertically, we always start with our ones place. So first, we will add 2 plus 3. We will write our answer, 5, below the ones place. What will we add next? Right, our tens place. When we add 4 plus 2, we get 6. Let's write that below in our tens place. Our answer is 65. Wow, adding the single digits in each place value was much quicker and easier than tackling the whole number at once. Let's practice this with subtraction. Just like addition, we will line up our tens and ones. Then we will subtract each place. What do you get when you subtract the ones? Good work. 5 minus 2 equals 3. We write that underneath the ones place. How about our tens place? Way to go. 5 minus 3 equals 2. We write that under our tens place. So our answer is 23. Did you write those answers in your guided notes? Awesome. Now I want to show you another powerful place value strategy. Flip to the next page in your notes. Does this look familiar? Right, this is a 100 chart. What do you notice about the numbers going down in this column? Look closely at the tens place. Yes, it's just like counting by tens. When we move vertically on a hundreds chart, we can add or subtract a 10. When we go up, our numbers get smaller, so we are subtracting 10. When we go down, the numbers get bigger, so we are adding 10. What about our numbers going across each row? You got it. If we go across our chart, we can add or subtract ones, like a number line. If we move backward or to the left, we are subtracting one. If we move forward or to the right, we are adding one. Let's try 25 plus 34 using our 100 chart. When we use this strategy, it's easier to start with the greater number. Which number is greater here? Yes, 34 is greater. Go ahead and find 34 on your 100 chart. Now, let's break 25 into tens and ones to help us add. First, we'll add the tens. How many tens are in 25? That's right, two tens or 20. Since we're adding, we move down two rows on our 100 chart. 10, 20. Now, are we done? Not yet. We still need to add our ones. Should we keep moving down? Nope. To add ones, we move across to the right. Since we have five ones, let's move right five spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And where do we land? That's right. Our answer is 59. Using a 100 chart helps us add by breaking numbers into tens and ones and making quick jumps instead of counting one by one. Great work. Let's try a subtraction problem. 76 minus 24. Which number should we find on our 100 chart to start? Nice work. We'll start at 76. Now remember, to subtract, we will move differently. How many tens are in the number 24? Yes, two. Which way will we move on our 100 chart to subtract two tens or 20? Awesome thinking. When we subtract, our number will get smaller, so we need to move up instead of down. How about our ones? To take away four, we must move backwards or to the left. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 76 minus 24 equals 52. I think we're ready for our quest. Let's use these strategies to solve 35 plus 62. Let's start by stacking our numbers vertically, lining up our tens and ones. What do you get when you add the ones? Yes, 5 plus 2 equals 7. How about our tens? Great work. 6 plus 3 equals 9. So our answer is 97. In math, it's always a good idea to check our work. Let's pull out our 100 chart to make sure we got this right. 62 is our bigger number, so we'll start there. Can you move down and across to add? We can move down three boxes to add three tens, or 30. Then we can go across five boxes to add five ones. We landed on 97. Nice work. Now we know we are ready to input our answer. Let's type it in. We did it. These strategies will be helpful as we continue to tackle problems with bigger numbers. Remember, every problem has a solution, and we've got the skills to solve it. See you next time. Hey.